Hey guys, welcome to part 9 of a beggar's journey. Before starting the video, I just wanted to point out that we are halfway towards the goal of hitting 14k subscribers. So if you're not subscribed, then by all means, go ahead and hit that red button for your boy. I also want to give a shout out to my Patreons. Your support is always greatly appreciated. The link to become a member will be in the description below. I will note that in this video, it will contain a lot of reading, so just be ready for that. So with nothing much more to say, let's dive back into the lore of DarkSydePhil.
Sadly, one of the issues that's been an ongoing thing that still, to this, is still giving me problems, is the biggest problem from last year. If you guys remember last year, 2017, my stuff was actually getting good. Like, I was starting to pay down my debts because of the money I was making on Twitch, the increase of money on Twitch. It was to the point where things were looking positive and good. Then all of a sudden, in the fall of last year, I got notice from the state income tax department for the state of Washington, where I live, that basically I was supposed to be paying state business income taxes for 4 years that I lived here, and my accountant, who was doing my taxes from back in Connecticut, did them all wrong. And I was like, oh shit, oh, it's a little bit of money? Oh no, it was a ton of money. It was a ridiculous amount of back taxes that I owed, plus fees and interest and all this stuff that they accumulated on top of everything, because I wasn't doing my taxes right for years and years and years, okay? So I'm now finding myself in a situation where basically I have between now and April, like say middle to late April, to raise an exorbitant amount of money. You may say, how much? I can just tell you this. This is an estimate of the amount of money I would need to raise between now and April. And by the way, this is the amount of money in addition to me making my normal money that I make every month on stream and every month on YouTube. In addition to my normal income, I need to raise about another roughly $16,000 between now and April. That really hurts to say that.
So in December of 2018, Phil announced to his fans that he owed a lot in back taxes, and he needed his fan support once again to get this paid off. And I think it's pretty safe to say that Phil was getting incredibly desperate during this time. And of course he pointed the finger at the trolls, because he wouldn't be having these issues if he was still with Curse.
It's an awful fucking feeling, knowing that by April, if I don't find a solution to pay these taxes, this could be the beginning of the end. The government comes and tries to either seize shit. I don't know how it works, but they might try to seize shit. They may say, that's it, you have to sell your house. And I was like, I can't afford it. Oh, too bad. Don't pay your credit cards. So not only would I lose my house, I'd also be forced to ruin my credit and lose the house at the same fucking time and have no money. It's like, for what? Because they fucked me again. Wow. Was it really worth it? Were your jollies really fucking worth it to get me out of my partnership? Was it really fucking worth it to do what you did to me? That now my life might be ruined? A beautiful woman who now I'm starting a life with my soulmate, and now that's going to fall the fuck apart? I mean, you know what I mean? And not to say that. That's not at all. She's 100% supportive of me. She understands what's going on. I don't want anyone to think, oh God, behind the scenes, this relationship's falling apart. It's not. But can you imagine the tremendous pressure on us now with all this going on? And it's like,
so after telling his fans that he needed them to pay for his own taxes, he gets contacted behind the scenes from a so-called fan. He tells him that he's been watching his content ever since he was back on his first channel, DarkSydePhil. DSP ended up taking the bait and responded to his email. I'll read out how the conversation went down. Hey Phil, I'm a massive fan of yours and have been for years now. Oddly enough, I started watching during your Splinter Cell Blacklist playthrough, maybe 5 or so years ago. I followed you on the internet for a long time and feel I owe it to you for all the free content you provided me and other fans. I'm mainly a YouTube viewer because I run my own business and I work crazy hours, so I really can't catch your stuff live. Anyways, I saw your video about how you needed financial help, and I feel like I'm one of your more qualified fans that might be able to help. Sorry about my rambling, Phil. The reason I'm writing you is that I like to make a sizable donation away from Twitch and don't want all the attention that comes with it. I don't really trust Twitch to handle this large amount of money, so I prefer to go through Western Union or somewhere slightly more reliable. I'm totally okay if you want to share with the fans that I'm helping you out. All I ask is that you don't mention me by name. But please feel free, and I actually encourage you to let people know an anonymous fan was able to help you out. I have had pretty good success in business, and so I did some number crunching, and came to the conclusion that I can donate roughly $9,000. It's a bit more than half of what you need, so I figure it'll help quite a bit. Like I said, I'll be doing this through Western Union or some other reliable way to transfer money. Please let me know if we can arrange this. I'd love to help you out, Phil. I know it sounds crazy, but I want to help out. And you provided me years of free content, and honestly, I can afford it. Let me know. Hello. First of all, thanks very much for your message and your offer. It's awesome to know I have so many longtime fans, even if I don't get to interact with you on screens every day. Splinter Cell Blacklist was over 8 years ago, when my original channel DarkSydePhil got suspended for false copyright infringement. So time flies. If this does happen, this would be a tremendous help for Kat and I. We've built our life here in the last 10 months since she moved in, and to be honest, it's been incredibly tough facing the fact that we may have to abandon all of that and move elsewhere because all of the stuff that's happened to us. So thank you for even considering this. I agree that if you're serious about a large donation to help, which by the way, 9K would be a tremendous amount, I would ask that you do not send it via Cheering or even PayPal. Cheering takes too long to clear and gets held up for months, and PayPal, sadly, is very open to fraudulent activities. So I say there's two real options here. Send a personal business check, since you own your own business, you know how that works, or Western Union. But I'm not aware at all of any fees or limitations that might happen if you use that method, as I've only used them once ever. Also, if this is 100% serious, then I'd like to ask that we do this after the 1st of January. Reason being, that puts it on the books for 2019 income, not 2018, and it wouldn't raise my income tax bill for 2018 at all, which would be absolutely tremendous help. If you were going to send a check, then you can literally send it at any time. I could just cash it after January 1st. But if it's Western Union, then we have to arrange specifics once the new year hits. In addition, I'd like to keep this 100% behind the scenes. If people, specifically those who do everything in their power to hurt me, got wind that someone was making a huge donation, they'd probably do everything they could to make my life a living hell. So better to just do it privately, and then hopefully I can find the rest of the money to pay these taxes next year, and we can move forward positively. Thanks so very much. Hope to hear back from you soon. Although honestly, I do feel very skeptical about this offer being real, because I've been trolled pretty hard and already. Many of those people pretended to be fans and said they would help, only to trick me afterward. So hopefully you are real, because this will really make Kat and I incredibly happy during this holiday season. Phil. The person behind this email later leaked the conversation shortly afterwards. It exposed that Phil would accept donation from fans behind the scenes and keep quiet about it while he was still crying poor on screen. After this email leak blew up in his face, Phil made a response about this on his pre-stream the next day.
Some people have, you know, messaged me pretending to be nice people. Oh, we're longtime fans, Phil, and we love your content, and we feel so bad that this is happening to you, and we want to reach out and help you. You know, I had one person who said, I have a couple thousand bucks maybe I'd like to send you. I had another person who actually said that they were going to be coming into some money, and they wanted to at least help me out. They couldn't pay the whole amount, but they didn't know how much they could do yet, yada, yada, yada. Basically, I had a bunch of people, about 12, who's all said this to me. And every single time, I'm not even kidding you, they came to me and said, oh, well, we don't want to have our information publicly disclosed, so we don't just want to just do a tip on your stream. We don't want to pledge to your Patreon because then we get attention for it. What we want to do is this is something we want to do behind the scenes, okay? Now, I'm not stupid, okay? I'm not stupid at all. I know that most of these, if not all of these people, are trolls. They're fucking with me. They're purposely doing this at a time when I'm at my weakest, because they know what bad financial situation I'm in. They're doing it to fuck with me. And what they're going to do is they're going to, at the last second, say, neener, 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 and pull the rug out from under me and say, ha ha, we fucked with you, we wasted your time, la la la, okay? Basically, one of the people who I responded to, I think this was a few days ago. This wasn't actually today. This was like a few days ago, I think. One of the 12 basically took my response to what he said and spun it to mean something that obviously it did not. If you actually read the fucking email word for word, you would definitely understand what was actually going on there, okay? But sadly, this guy is doing this on purpose to basically make me look bad. So he wrote me a message. His original message said that he's a business owner or whatever. He wants to send me $9,000, okay? But he doesn't want to do it on stream, and he doesn't want to do Patreon. What he wants to do is he wants to do it behind the scenes via, say, Western Union or something like that, something off stream outside of that, because he doesn't want to get any kind of attention for himself, because he's afraid that if he gets any attention for himself, the information will get out there, someone might negatively affect him or whatever. But Basically, I said, I would prefer, if you really wanted to remain anonymous, prefer to just not talk about it at all. Because the bottom line is, if I talk about it, that's when all the trouble happens. Whenever I talk about something publicly, all right, basically that's when the trouble happens. The guy now posts it publicly on Twitter and says, oh, see, Phil didn't want to publicly talk about this because he wanted to fool the fans. He wanted to take my $9,000, which is bullshit because it's not. It's from some fucking kid pretending, of course. He said he wanted to take $9,000, from me and then keep it and not tell the fans and then still take more money than he actually needed on top of that, all right, to put towards this and then basically make tons of money behind the scenes and tell no one. So basically what he's saying is, not that I want to protect his fucking, his identity, you know what I mean? Which is exactly what he wanted. No, that's not why I'm doing it, because I'm trying to steal money. Again, everything, anything I possibly fucking do, it's because I'm a horrible thief, I'm the devil, I'm a criminal, I'm a terrible person.
A little fun thing to mention, that's not really important, but I figured we'd talk about it anyway. A couple of days later, DSP put out a tweet making fun of the well-known Twitch streamer Ninja that stated, "Which is man, which is Muppet? LOLOL. Seems like something I've been saying all along is definitely true. This pic is priceless." He later went on to get blasted in the replies. I guess he forgot about that whole depression shit he tried to pull when this happened before. He later took down the tweet and said the reason he insulted Ninja was because he was afraid of losing his home.
Alright, I owe everyone an apology. I must stop being petty about people like Ninja and others being successful. My attitude is a direct result of being at risk to lose my home. I am sorry and will do better, especially now during the holiday season. It's just wrong. First of all, he'd been petty towards people that were more successful than him for like the last 5 years.
And you really have to commend Ninja for never reacting to the bullshit DSP says about him. For as much as DSP like to claim to be the underdog and a man of the people, he sure loves to shit talk people unprovoked just for being more successful than he is. DSP proved to be more desperate as he responded to another bait email who pretty much ran with the same story the last guy did. The only difference with this one was the guy wanting to get some autographed statues signed by DSP himself. DSP was willing to ship out the statues once he received the money. And bro, some of these statues were not in good condition. So this dude was actually willing to give his fans broken statues in order to receive $6,000 to pay these back taxes. I have never seen a screamer more desperate for cash in my life. Now, there are a lot of emails to go through, so I'm going to give my voice a break and let Tevin read out a couple emails to give you a general idea how this all went down.
Text fun. I can send you $6,000. Hey Phil, I wanted to aid you on your tax issue. Is there a way for me to send you cash via Apple Pay, Patreon, or PayPal? I was wondering if you could send me one of your figures. You can autograph it, and I'd be more than happy to help out with your finances. It's not like you're paying for a statue to me. I live in Seattle, so the shipping isn't a problem. We could have met up in person. Yo, he should have fucking asked him to meet up in person and told him to go to the mall or some shit. And then he would have came back in the email like, what the fuck, you didn't show up? That would have been godlike. Oh, well. I hope I can help because I'm a big fan and I'm heartbroken to see you suffering through some tough times. Please get back to me soon. Super Me Boy 7. A.K.A. Jonathan Rivas. If you are serious, then thanks. I'd be more than willing to part with one of my statues and mail it to you. No shit, he doesn't even look at them. He should give him all of his statues for $6,000. Which one are you interested in? The best way to do this will be sending me a personal check. Reason being, once cash, there's no way to commit fraud. Patreon would be great. But your personal info, i.e. name on Patreon, yes, Patreon name's all personal, will be exposed publicly and show that you did a huge donation. It would also publicly show on my Patreon page, and I don't want that. I wonder why I don't want that. PayPal is great because I get the funds right away, but I learned from that person who tried and charged back all of his tips this year that you could potentially try to charge me back for quite a few months. However, it wouldn't work, as PayPal has sided with me every single time. Worthless details. What is the point of putting this in? If PayPal always take his side, why the fuck he's so scared of getting money through PayPal? Maybe he should stop talking about chargebacks so much. So, I say mailing me a personal check is best, but if you cannot do that, PayPal is second best. DSPGaming@hotmail.com is the address to send it to, but do it manually through PayPal and not through my tips thing on stream. Else it will be public and cause drama for sure. All right, we got the reply. I can do that. Do you bank? Do you bank? I get it. Do you bank via your phone? I can send you a picture of the check to make your life easier. I don't recall the figures you have because it was a long time ago. Maybe some pictures of the figures just to make sure there's no damage on them. Multiple figures of damage, by the way. He tried to sell legit broken figures on fucking YouTube. I'm worrisome to use Patreon and PayPal because the trolls will get my personal information and dox me. Oh no! I can mail the check too. What's the address to mail to? Jesus Christ, DSP, I hope you didn't tell him his address. I want to help, but I don't want to have my name exposed. I'm trusting you as a longtime fan to keep my name private. I want to do my best to help you make amends and see through this time. Your friend. Well, sadly, since you last emailed me, a troll who has made a similar offer and also said they wanted me to keep the info totally private just outright lied on Twitter, saying it was my idea and I wanted to hide the fact from my fans that I was getting money in an effort to milk more out of them. I did a whole video on that. I'll put the link to that in the description. If it was a lie, you would think he would at least publish the emails, but he didn't. Therefore, if you want to contribute, I have to insist you do it through tipping me via PayPal or via Patreon. However, since we've talked ahead of time, you can make a dummy name or even tip anonymously on my stream. No fucking shit. Tell me it's coming, and I'll know it was you, so we can discuss one of the figures to send you. FYI, I will not have your personal info via this method. That's a lie. And nobody will be able to get it either, unless they was to legit hack you, which isn't going to happen. Let me know what you think, and thanks. Same from my iPhone. Here are the pics as we discussed it. Paragraphs, by the way. Here are the pics as we discussed it. First, Emma Frost. It's flawless. Smallest of three you're interested in. And I could probably ship it fast, as USPS would allow me to have it picked up from here and send it direct to you within a few days. Then there's Poison Ivy. It's a full-size figure. Very nice. Also, no flaws or problems at all. The Monster Buds, you see, are interchangeable. And there are two extras in the box that are smaller versions with the mouth closed. So you can change on how it looks depending on your liking. Then there's Scorpion. I'll be honest. It's nice, but it has issues. It has interchangeable heads, so you can either have the normal one, no, the normal human one, or the skull, or the flaming skull, all of which are nice. But two things are a problem. First, the hands. You can see sticking out the base. The ones grabbing at Scorpion's legs had the glue wear off on them in less than a year. They sit firmly in the base, but the magnets that were supposed to be glued on them are now permanently stuck in place in the notches on the base. So the hands aren't 100% firmly snug in there, but as long as you don't pick it up or swing it around, they should stay in fine. He wants to send him a broken statue. However, you may notice the blade in the upper left hand or of his upper left hand corner of his right knee is snapped off. It's made of pretty brittle plastic. I was just touching it normally on the day, one day years ago, and it snapped off of my hand, of course. It was touching it normally. The good news is I still have the piece and put it inside of a small plastic bag. And it's the bag with the statue. So nothing is missing at all. But you probably need to glue that blade back into place if you wanted to. So out of the three you're interested in, this one has flaws, while the other two, flawless. So again, let me know what you think. And also, please let me know when you plan on sending a donation, so I know to look, I know when to be looking out for it. Thanks. Yo, he took the pictures too. These are some pretty high quality pictures. Shout out to the iPhone. Look at that butt. It's pretty good. Look at a little scorpion. Look at this dude. Look at this time, nigga. Nigga, it's the same day. It's the same day. 5 a.m. So 3 a.m. for him. 3 a.m.
After these emails were leaked to the public, DSP made this statement on his Twitter longer. In regards to me being catfished with offers of fake support in order to spin it as lies and make me look bad, Over the last 2 weeks, I received about a dozen messages via emails and PMs from various sources. These messages all claim to be longtime fans who have heard of my current financial situation and want to help out. Some even go as far to reference old playthroughs or their favorite moments from my content over the last 10 years. The messages have been for offers as low as a few hundred dollars to as high as 9K. And every single one so far has asked that if they did donate to help, that I keep it private to avoid drama and keeping their names out of the public eye so that my haters and detractors could not seek out their personal information or harass them in real life. In fact, I just got one today from someone saying they'll send me 6K because they want to buy one of my statues autographed and help out. I responded in the same way I have to all the others, incredibly skeptical, but hopeful that one of them will help. Now, I'm not stupid. I firmly know that most, if not all, offers like that are going to be fake. Most people who want to help would just attend the screen and send a tip, or pledge to my Patreon, etc., and would not be sending me separate messages. But I have to at least respond to each message positively and with hope, as I'm in dire financial scrapes and need to at least think that maybe one of these offers would be real. So far, they haven't been. However, today one of those dishonest people took my response to their email out of context and presented it to social media as if I were the one who had requested to keep the entire thing private and outside of the public eye. That is not the case at all. I would gladly celebrate receiving a large donation to help with my situation on the screen or otherwise, but this person up front said that they didn't want any info about their donation getting out, and even suggested using behind-the-scenes method like Western Union as a way to send the funds. If you like my content, or you like me as a person, or both, I would gladly accept any help you can offer. I would never make a personal request to keep it private, as if I were going to accept tons of behind-the-scenes donations and then keep telling my viewers that I need more. That, quite frankly, is insane to me. I've never been that kind of person, and I never will be. I'm only here because of you and your support, and I would never take advantage of it in any method that would violate the trust between us for personal gain. Why on earth would I risk that in the amazing 10-year relationship we've built for the chance of short-term personal gain?
Thank you very much too. It was Emerald7 who just gifted 50 subscriptions. Emerald7, thank you very much. We have now hit the sub goal for the month. I'll be doing the retrospective event in January. Very nice. Holy shit, Emerald7 is gifting another 50 subs. Holy crap, guys. Emerald7 is dropping the fucking sub bombs today. Damn. Oh my god, Emerald7 just gifted another 50 subs. Are you serious? Are you freaking serious, dude? Are you serious? We're up to 696 subscriptions. God damn. God damn.
So a fucking dinhead by the name of Emerald7 just randomly showed up to Phil's stream one day and just started throwing money at this nigga like he was a stripper. He was gifting massive amounts of subs, and you're probably thinking to yourself, this dude sounds really familiar. And yes, he does. Cause afterwards, some people were thinking this was King Tut crawling back to Phil under a new Twitch account. This guy had never interacted with Phil or appeared in chat, so it was really suspicious for a guy like this just to show up out of nowhere. A Twitch moderator even showed up to the stream, but he was only there to congratulate Phil for getting over 1k subs. Emerald7 had gifted DSP so many subs that he became number one on Twitch for the highest amount of tier 3 subs. DSP made a special video a little bit afterwards and thanked Emerald7 for all the gifted subs he gave his cult members.
The bottom line is, here's what I want to happen. First of all, being very honest with all of you, right now, because of the help that Emerald7 gave me with those gifted subs, okay, earlier this month, I'll see some of that income. I'll see that in February. That's going to help a big chunk of the federal taxes that I owe come April, okay? Phew, thank God, because I haven't paid any of them. I haven't had any money to pay them, right? What I'm hoping is that between now and April, I can see significant amount of support coming out of the streams, and maybe I could get a little bit more, you know, we're working on stuff behind the scenes here. Kat's working on stuff. We're doing as much as we possibly can to make as much money as we can to pay these taxes coming up in April.
He also mentioned that he needed to go visit his parents, since he believed he didn't have that much time to spend with them, despite the fact that he still didn't have all the funds to pay for his back taxes. But to save face and still cry poor on screen, DSP informs his fans that his parents will be paying for all the travel fees so they can see him and Kat in person.
There is some stuff going on in my life right now, personally, that I have really not mentioned a lot. That I do need to bring up now, okay? And please understand this is very personal to me. This is very private, but it's something that I want to bring up because it's serious, a serious matter, all right? So, in 2019, at some point, whether sooner or later, I'm going to end up having to go back to Connecticut. I talked to my parents about this, and they told me that I could 100% talk to you guys about it and reveal anything I wanted and be honest with you. I told them I was doing this podcast today, and they said, yes, please go ahead and tell them whatever you want. My parents aren't doing so well, all right? They're getting old, and my mom has had a lot of health issues over the years already. The last few years, you guys noticed I haven't really talked about my dad that much. It's because he's not doing very well. My dad is getting a lot of health issues, both his back, which he basically has, remember my back issue, my herniated disc? Well, he has at least two, if not three, in the same situation that I had. So he's really fucked up right now and can barely move around. He's been like this for about 2 years now. And now he's starting to have other health problems. He's starting to have heart problems, okay? So it's a bad situation. It's really bad. Well, the bottom line is they're not doing very well at all, okay? And immediately you get a dickhead like ITG Jake. I'm going to read it because I've had enough and he's permanently banned now. Do you want us to give you money to see your parents? Fuck you, Jake. How about that? Fuck you. No, because you don't wait 5 seconds to let me finish what I'm saying. Now, not only are you permanently banned, but now we all get to laugh at you publicly for being an insensitive piece of fucking shit when I'm bearing my heart to the fucking stream. Go fuck yourself. No, I'm not asking anyone for money to go to Connecticut to see my parents. In fact, it's the actual complete polar opposite situation, okay? My parents have basically told me that since, you know, this is a circumstance where they absolutely, not only obviously do they want to spend time with me, they want to meet Kat. You know, Kat has lived with me for almost a year, and I'll be very honest with all of you, I would love to marry her someday. I have no idea if that's in the cards with everything, the way things have been going financially and everything, but obviously I've told my parents this and they're like, we want to meet her. Like, this is amazing. We want to meet her and spend time with her. Kat is a cat lover. My parents own three cats who they would like to, she would like to meet, obviously. and basically, you know, it's a situation where even though this is not, no way, okay, is this the best time for this to happen, for me to take time away from work and streaming? It's basically at this point a necessity, a make or break. If I don't go to visit my parents sometime in 2019, I may never see them again. You see what I mean? And it may be one or both. I don't know. They don't know. You know, they're basically telling me we have health issues and we want to see you and we want to meet Kat and we want to spend time with you. My parents' health is so bad they can't even come out here to see me, which sucks. And it really is sad because I thought years ago when they visited me, it might have been one of the last times. But then their health got even worse after that. And I'm just like, you know, with everything else going around, everything else happening, with all the stress and everything going on, this is something that has to happen.
And I guess my final thoughts for this video would be, fuck Emerald 7. If it wasn't for that total of $12K he donated to Phil, we could have gotten so much entertainment out of DSP during January. He would have been so toxic towards his fans, because at this time, his back was truly against the wall. He would have had to move out of that gated community, and Kat would have either packed his shit and move on to the next guy, or move back into the condo with Phil. The gold dust he would have provided during those 3 months would have been legendary, and it's all thanks to one retarded cook that we never got a chance to truly see that side, a DarkSydePhil. Alright guys, that'll do it for part 9 of A Beggar's Journey. Shout out to my Patreons, Mark Wisniewski, Joel, Sexy Mustang 10, and Noto Pico. Your support is greatly appreciated. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more content just like this. I'll see you for part 10. Stay strong, brothers.
Just get Kat a cat. That is not a consideration anytime soon until we get past other hurdles. So.